Hello everyone, welcome to AptiPlus Academy for Civil Services. This is a video on daily topic 5 news and editorial analysis, which I'll be covering from the Hindu and Indian Express. So the most important news and editorial will be discussed in this session. So let's get started with the topic first. Today is 8th of July. The first topic is India-Iran strengthening the diplomatic relation. Second, the new platform for the Pegasus spread. Third, SC Direct to file status report on the vacancies which is pending. Second last, Fed to cut GDP growth estimate due to the slower recovery of the economy. And third, challenging negative social norms. So this is an editorial from the Hindu. Apart from all the news and editorial discussion, there would be some MCQs question. These questions would be based on current affairs that will help you in the upcoming prelims examination. Those of you who are new to our channel, do not forget to subscribe. AptiPlus Academy for Civil Services on YouTube. If you like this video, do not forget to give a thumbs up. The first news of the day, that is India-Iran strengthening the diplomatic relations. Important for your General Studies Paper 2, Effect of Policies and Politics for the Developed and Developing Countries. Also, it will help you some fodder point for the prelims examination for the direct question relations to the map work. So what was there in the news? That the India's External Affairs Minister, Mr. S. Jaishankar, he has become the first foreign dignitary to meet the newly elect president, that is Ibrahim Raisi, right? Abhi nahi appointment hui unke baad, he would be the first foreign dignitary from any country to meet him, right? So this is a goodwill gestures from Iran and a proactive role from India towards the Iran. And the minister has handed over a personal message by the Prime Minister of India on the Iran president-elect. So a congratulation message, which was a customized personal message from the Prime Minister of India, was handed over to him, right? So these are some of the diplomatic courtesy which is usually being followed. Now, agenda of the meeting, why this meeting is important with the Iran, as there's a change of the government, change of the presidentship. So it is becoming very important that we have some proactiveness in terms of building a relationship. So the External Affairs Minister, both countries held a discussion on the regional and global issues, right? So these were the two important issues that they discussed. Now, the present situation in Afghanistan figured prominently in the talk, right? The Iranian foreign minister stressed on the need to strengthening the intra-Afghan dialogue that could result in the comprehensive political partnership in Afghanistan, right? So, kuch important situation in Afghanistan ke issues ko lekar ki, we know that the US forces has left many of the Afghanistan places. Now it called for the peace process and democratic stabilizations of the government there, right? So a government which is democratically elected in Afghanistan would be more important rather than any other militant group occupying the space, right? So kuch important intra-Afghan dialogue ko lekar ke bhi baat hui hai. Comprehensive political partnership in Afghanistan is mandatory. Now, kuch aur situation ki agar baat kare Gulf region ko lekar ke, so Vienna talk is again on the reviving. Iran ke jo nuclear deal hai, also these two important points, the nuclear, Iran nuclear deal and the Chabahar project port. So these two were some of the important points which India also want to contribute and play a role, right? And issues concerning that decision, jahan pe India ki jo oil imports hai, uske liye usme bhi sanctions lagai gayi thi. This started in May 2019 owing an American sanctions under the Trump administration. Now the Trump administration is no more. The US presidentship is under the Joe Biden, right? And now they want, actually they have a good relationship. India had a good relationship with US as well. So वहाँ से चीजें हमारे को बहुत हद तक solve हुई है. Now they want कि जो sanctions हैं अब वो lift करके India भी वापस उनसे import करे oil को. Now the visit of India's External Affairs Minister is aimed at preparing the annual India-Russia summit, right? So the Foreign Minister of India or External Affairs Minister of India, S. Jaishankar, he's on a way that he'll be also referring to Russia He's coming from Russia also. So discussions on the Afghanistan issue between India, Russia and Iran is again something which is very important. Now, Iran's role in Afghan peace process, along with Russia, Iran has been playing a major role in Afghanistan peace process. Right? Afghan peace process is again very important for India, and a direct question in the mains examination this time is expected on this topic. Right, so make sure you have ample content on APP, that is Afghan peace process. So renewed momentum ki baat ki gayi hai, renewed momentum ki zarurat hai, jis tarah se withdrawal hui hai US forces ki, uske baad this is very important that by September 11 many of the forces which is there deployed in the Afghanistan region would be moving back to the US. And other news, new platform maps, Pegasus spread. This is important for your general studies paper 3. Awareness in the field of IT also important in the same paper for the security concern. Pegasus, how does it work, is again something which is very, very important for your prelims examination. Now, a team of independent researchers, they have found that kuch aise group the jinhone map kiya, target kiya individual logo ko. They people were from the community of celebrities, journals, human rights activists, and the device was hacked using a malware known as Pegasus. Right? This is a spyware which is being developed by the Israeli company NSO Group. So Pegasus, spyware, and NSO Group, these three names are very important. They can ask you, what is a platform? This is a Pegasus. What is Pegasus? This is a spyware. Who developed it? By the NSA group, which is there in Israel, right? So these facts are important. Now, baat karega online database ki, to jo spyware hai Pegasus, wo recently forensic architectures jo hai, Amnesty International ke aur Citizen Lab hai, in dono ne is cheez ki khulasa kiya hai. They have come up with evidence that the document attacks human rights activist defender were used by the software or the spyware known as Pegasus. किसके क्या क्या कॉन्सिक्वेंसेज हो सकते हैं पेगासस के, किस तरह की आपको इसमें इंटरफेरेंस मिल जाती, कितनी एक्सेस मिलती है फोन की, आई टेल यू आर डिटेल अबाउट दैट एज वेल. नो व्हाट वर द फाइंडिंग ऑफ द एमनेस्टी इंटरनेशनल, राइट, एक बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन है, एनजीओ है, जिन्होंने कहा है कि जो स्पाईवेयर है वो एक मेजर प्लेयर एक्ट कर रही थी इन द acting as a surveillance company, right? Pegasus ne pehle bhi kaha hai, they have the most indigenous digital attack aur human rights activists jitne the across the world, un pe ye operate kar rahi thi through their spyware, right? So spyware enable the attackers to get complete access to the personal phone. Ek individual ki phone pe uski complete access ho sakti hai, from its contacts, data, email, social media apps, everything can have a access via this spyware. नाउ भीमा गाँव गोरेगाँव की जो केस है, भीमा गोरेगाँव केस में भी इसमें बहुत सारे ऐसे लोग होते हैं जिनकी डेथ हुई है. एंड डिजिटल वॉयलेंस डॉट ऑर्ग लिस्ट आउट दैट द टारगेट ऑफ द स्पाईवेयर इन इंडिया इंक्लूड एक्टिविस्ट फ्रॉम द भेला भाटिया एंड आनंद टेलटुम्बेड, राइट. सो दीज वर द टू नेम. एंड एमनेस्टी एंड सिटीजन लैब, दे हैव रिपील्ड जो स्पाईवेयर थी दैट वर यूज्ड फॉर 9 ह्यूमन राइट डिफेंडर्स हु वर एक्यूज्ड इन द भीमा गोरेगाँव केस, राइट. So Father Stanley was among them who was accused in the Bhima Koregaon case, but he always said that he has no relation, he has recently been dead. You must be aware of this fact. Now about Pegasus spyware ki agar baat kare, NSA group in Israel, they developed it. Now basically it's a technology cyber security firm. और पेगासस की बात करें, ये एक ऐसी मैलवेयर है जो पूरी कंट्रोल देती है एक्सेस टू द इन्फेक्टेड स्मार्टफोन, उसके माइक्रोफोन्स को, कैमरा को, एंड इवन एक्सेस टू द मैसेजेस, ईमेल्स एंड कलेक्ट लोकेशंस डेटा, राइट. सो दिस इज हाउ द सॉफ्टवेयर, द पोटेंशियल ऑफ द मैलवेयर इज इन टर्म्स ऑफ इफ द एंटर इन एनी फोन. बहुत ज़्यादा हाईली पोटेंट स्पाईवेयर है जो किसी भी तरह की इंफॉर्मेशन आपसे फ़ोन से ले सकती है. Now, does it affect other apps? Definitely, Pegasus allow controller to access a smartphone, mic, camera, but it does not mention that it can affect other applications. It has not been clear. Pegasus has not made it officially announced that whether they have access to particular applications or not, But the controller can have access to files, images, and even the encrypted message. Like WhatsApp is end-to-end encrypted, so that particular message can also be viewed. Now, as per the Kaspersky is world's best antivirus that was reported. So, उन्होंने कहा है कि Pegasus even allow you to listen the encrypted audio streams and read encrypted messages, right? So, basically the hacker have the access to the entire phone. So you can see the potential of this Pegasus malware. Once it is, if it has been controlled in any phone, they can reach out to n number of files and n number of access to the data. Now, SC directs to file status report on vacancies. The Supreme Court is taking a proactive role. And this would be important for your important aspects of governance, transparency, and accountability. Also important for the role of judiciary in the public services. So what Supreme Court has noted, they have directed the center and state government to file a status complying 2019 judgment, jahan pe unhone kaha tha ki jo vacant positions hain, इन्फॉर्मेशन कमिश्नर की, स्टेट इन्फॉर्मेशन कमिश्नर्स की, उनको विद इन डेडलाइन फिल करने की ज़रूरत है. बट दिस हैज़ नॉट हैपेंड. सो अगेन सुप्रीम कोर्ट हैड गिवन अ बज टू द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट्स. नाउ द कोर्ट फोकसेस अपॉन द वैकेंसीज पेंडिंग इन द सेंट्रल इन्फॉर्मेशन कमीशन, जो CIC अगेंस्ट द मोस्ट पावरफुल बॉडी, एंड द स्टेट इन्फॉर्मेशन कमीशन SIC के बारे में बात की है, राइट? सो दे हैव पुल्ड अप बोथ द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एंड द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट. नाउ एक प्ली फाइल की गई थी RTI एक्टिविस्ट की. सो दे हैव फाइल्ड अ प्ली इन द सुप्रीम कोर्ट, राइट? एंड द कोर्ट हैज डायरेक्टेड द सेंटर एंड द स्टेट टू फिल अप द वैकेंसीज. जो भी स्टेट्स में या जो सेंटर में वैकेंसीज हैं, दे शुड बी फिल अप विद इन 6 months, राइट? सो दिस इज अ डेडलाइन दैट द सुप्रीम कोर्ट हैज गिवन, राइट? सो द बेंच इज लुकिंग फॉर अ हियरिंग ऑफ द प्ली दैट वॉज फाइल्ड इन 2018 बाय द RTI एक्टिविस्ट. Now, the plea has played a direction for urgently fulfilling the vacancies of Information Commissioner and the State Information Commissioner. Say, two positions ke liye, isme activist, majority activist, unhone plea file ki hai Supreme Court. Now, what are the selection procedures for the Chief Election Commissioners and the State Election Commissioner? So, under Right to Information Act 2005, jo members hote hain Chief Election Commissions ke, they are selected by the Prime Minister, leader for positions, and Union Cabinet Minister nominated by the Prime Minister. This is the composition of the selection committee. If you talk about the state election commissioners, they are selected by the Chief Minister, which is the head of the Council of the State, leader of other positions, state assemblies, and one cabinet minister nominated by the Chief Ministers, right? So you can say more stake is always there with the ruling party, right? So what is the other procedure? What is the working of CIC and State IC? You should understand the basic concept. These are very relevant for the prelims examination in your polity sections, right? Now, the other news, Fitch cut GDP growth estimate due to slower recovery. Important for your General Studies Paper 3, inclusive growth and issues arising from it. A predictions regarding the economy growth and recovery. So recently the Fitch rating, they have cut their estimate and forecast for the current fiscal. This is the 10%. Now they have come up to 10%. Earlier estimate was that it would grow to 12.8%. So the Fitch rating agency is a very reputed, trusted, authentic rating agency, which ratings and predictions, the government bhi, take it as a notion and understand that yes, this is something we can grow for. So, pehle 12.8% Kaspersky anticipations thi, that has reduced to 10%. And the main reason was slowing recovery post second wave of the COVID-19, right? Now, the rating agency has said ki jo rapid vaccinations hain, there could be a sustainable revival in the business across the consumer confidence. Now, challenges kya kya hain is wajah se, jo recovery nahi ho pa rahi hai. तो चैलेंजेस टू द बैंकिंग सेक्टर्स की अगर बात करें, सो द बैंकिंग रेटिंग एजेंसी, द ग्लोबल रेटिंग एजेंसी ने कहा कि बैंकिंग सेक्टर प्रपोज्ड द कोरोना वायरस पेंडेमिक एंड इंक्रीज्ड ड्यू टू द वर्लुएंट सेकेंड वेव. वी हैव सीन द फर्स्ट वेव हैज ऑलरेडी इम्पैक्टेड द कंट्री, बट इन लेस इंटेंसिटी ऑफ टाइम द सेकेंड वेव हैज मोर सीवियर इफेक्ट इन द सेवरल सेक्टर इंक्लूडिंग द बैंकिंग, राइट? सो सेकेंड वेव इन द फर्स्ट ऑफ द फाइनेंशियल क्वार्टर ऑफ द मार्च वॉज नॉट वेरी वेल. Now, the rating agency has warned the asset क्वालिटी चैलेंजेस हैव इंक्रीज्ड, जहाँ पे कुछ थ्रेट्स दैट स्टिल रिमेन. फर्स्ट इज द मोबिलिटी रिस्ट्रिक्शंस, मेडिकल एजेंसीज, राइजिंग जॉब लॉसेज विद द माइक्रो स्मॉल एंड मीडियम एंटरप्राइजेस, रिटेल टू लोन एंड मॉडरेट इनकम्स, एंड बोरोवर्स आर अनलाइकली मोस्ट लाइकली अवेयर एट द रिस्क. सो लो मॉडरेट बोरोवर्स वर मोस्टली एट द रिस्क बिकॉज ऑफ द हाइएस्ट इन्फ्लेशन रेट एंड द इंटरेस्ट रेट्स. Now they have predicted about the GDP growth, the trend of the GDP growth. If you see, so Indian economy contracted by 7.3% in the fiscal 2021. Country ki jo battle hai first wave of COVID-19 mein, that is against the 4% of the growth, right? And GDP growth in the current fiscal was estimated to the double digit initially, but jis tarah se waves continue hi hai, the projection has deteriorated to the single digit itself. And even not only the rating agency, even our government agency and the apex regulator, that is RBI, right, jo hamare central bank hai, unhone bhi kaha hai ki jo growth rate hai forecast, they have cut to 9.5% from 10%. So from double digit, RBI, the apex bank of the country, the central bank of the country, has also reduced the projection to 9.5%. Now the other news, this is an editorial from the Hindu talking about challenging negative social norm. So this is important for your general studies paper 2, welfare schemes for the vulnerable section of population by the centers and the states. So what are the important issues under this editorial? The first is Guttmacher Lancet Commission formula, development goals, challenges for the next generation, sexual and reproductive health indicators, poor indicators and way forward. So these are some of the subtopics upon which I'll be discussing the entire editorial. Aur is editorial ki theme ki baat kare, so is editorial mein baat ki gayi hai India population jo stabilization strategy wo kya honi chahiye aur jo gender gap hai wo kaise fulfill ho sakti hai aur India ki kya kya advantages present time mein hai, right? So is editorial mein jo main concern ki gayi hai ki jis tarah se covid ke time mein pandemic mein we are celebrating the world population day on July 11th, kuch positive news hai yahan pe regarding the world population, right? So India has entered into the demographic sweet spot. So if you're writing a mains aur aap agar population ke bare mein likh rahe hain to you should include these points ki India has entered into the demographic sweet spot that continued for another 2 to 3 decades. To aane wale 20 se 30 saal tak ye continue rahegi. Aur ye sweet decade ka matlab ye hai, sweet spot ka matlab ye hai ki jo hamari average population hai India ki, that has become 29 of age, right? Iska matlab ye hua ki India ke paas ek aisi population hai, ek aisi pool of population hai young people ki jo hamare economic growth aur social progress mein madad kar sakti hai. But the fact is that we need to potentially use this energy in the right direction, right? Aur jo young population hai, they must be provided with the right to choice and to develop it fully potential. Ye potential kaise mil sakti hai unko? By including especially the sexual and reproductive health and rights. So every rights has to be provided to each and every individual with this potential age group. Now, Guttmacher Lancet Commission ki ek formula hai, unhone kaha hai, they are improving the SRHR population formula in comprehensive definitions. Aur jo basic cheeze include ki gayi hai, that include jaise violence, stigma, respect of bodily autonomy, greater impact of psychological, emotional and well-being of the individual. So they are more concerned to the female, right? So the female liberty and equality is something which is very, very important. डेवलपमेंटल गोल्स की बात करें, इंडिया ने कहा है कि जो पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ जिस तरह से स्टेबलाइज हो रही है, द पॉपुलेशन विल कंटिन्यू टू ग्रो बिकॉज ऑफ इट्स इफेक्ट ऑन पॉपुलेशन मोमेंटम. अगर TFR की बात करें, टोटल फर्टिलिटी रेट, तो प्रेजेंटली TFR 2.2% पे, एट 2.2% चिल्ड्रन विद सून रिप्लेसमेंट रीचिंग टू 2.1% लेवल, राइट? जो TFR है दैट रिमेन हाइएस्ट द नेशनल एवरेज 2.2% चिल्ड्रन पे. बट अमंग वुमेंस की अगर बात करें, रूरल एरियाज, दे आर लिटिल फॉर्मल एजुकेशन, राइट? वी नो दैट द टर्म्स ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड द लेवल ऑफ हेल्थ केयर इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर्स और जो नॉलेज है हेल्थ के रिलेटेड, वो भी बहुत पुअर है अर्बन एरिया, बेसिकली रूरल एरियाज, ऑल्सो इन द अर्बन एरियाज, कंपेरेटिवली रूरल एरिया में ज़्यादा पुअर है. एंड द लोवेस्ट इनकम क्वांटिल ऑफ द मेजोरिटी आर सीन इन द पुअर स्टेट. So we need to have an informed decision. We need to make people, women, even the male, to understand about how the improvement of health can be improved through the diet and other important parts. Now, challenges for the next generations, right? जो generations हैं उनके लिए जो social norms है, is one of the biggest challenge. India is to address the needs of the next generations. अगर COVID की बात करें, COVID pandemic has exposed the weakness. Healthcare has led to serious gaps in challenging the provisions. Informations की अगर बात करें, sex, reproductive health. So these are some of the important points that need to focus upon to ensure the potential is fully used. Now, any further delays will curtail the health and well-being of a woman and girl, consensus of which would cast a lifetime, right? Now, talking about the sexual and reproductive health indicators, yahan pe basically 2 decades mein India has made a substantial progress on this indicators. This is SRH, right? SRH indicators. So positive policies की अगर बात करें, maternal health has also resulted improvement. जो institutional delivery है, that has also improved and decline in the maternal mortality rate. MMR भी decrease हुई है. पहले ये 327 हुआ करती थी per lakh. Now it is around 130, right? So National Family Health Survey के मुताबिक, people are using some contraceptive prevalence that has improved further in most of the states. So this is the by the report of the survey, National Family Health Survey 5. Now some poor indicators which has been shown in this editorial, this talks about the challenges on the path of 2030 of achieving the sustainable development goal. Jo goal post hai hamari SDG ki, usme usko achieve karna bhi ek target hai India ke liye. 2 million adolescents girl, agar baat kare 15 to 19 ki age group mein, they have been seen with the earlier pregnancy, and nearly 63% of the women were unwanted and unintended, right? So this is what the report has quoted. And girls are still marrying too young. 26% women's ke agar baat kare, they get married at the age of 20 to 24 before turning into the age 80, right? And too many girl women face gender-based violence, harmful practices of the social sanction. So again, gender-based violence, like cases from the dowry and other domestic violence, always in high in India. So India has slipped 28 positions on rank 2 from 148 to 156 and become the worst performer in the South Asia in terms of the World Economic Forum gender gap report, right? So gender gap report mein hamari performance bhi bahut poor hai. So a question can be asked in mains, that what do you understand that things can be done to improve the global gender gap reports? Now way forward, these are some of the suggestions that you can include. The India's population stabilization strategy must be adjusted, keeping in mind the right of women and girls. And women must have the greater say and choice in the family size. So what should be a family size of an individual family, how many children they want, it should be the stay of a woman, and they should have the more right and more dominance right in choosing the number of families, right? Number of actually the child. So the stakeholder has to build a new set of social norm in driving the missions. Now government ne current mein Bechi Bachao Beti Padhao, PPP Beti Bachao Beti Padhao abhiyan launch kiya tha. So this has efforts to launch existing social norm, and it has impacted me in many states, giving up positive sentiments towards higher girls' educations, right? And all sections of society must embrace this positive change. So zarurat hai ki ek hierarchy pe hame kaam karne ki. From the ground level and approaching a bottom-up approach, we need to work and implement this Beti Bachao Beti Padhao abhiyan. And UNFPA is keen on taking India's success model on strengthening the South-South collaboration further, right? So these are some of the way forward that you can write in your mains answers. Coming to the MCQs questions, before I proceed with the question, just to tell you the answers of yesterday question. So for the first question, the correct option is C. For the second question, the correct option is D. Question of the day. Consider the statement with regards to World Sustainable Development Summit 2021. It is an annual flagship summit organized by the Greenpeace. The theme for 2021 summit was Redefine Our Common Future, Save the Environment for All, right? So A, B, C or D, whatever you feel is the correct answer, you can let us know in the comment section down below. Second, consider the statement about Saksham, that is a dynamic portal for the job mapping and skill of the Shramik, MSME and other standards in the country. The portal uses algorithm and artificial intelligence tool that provide analysis and the skill training program for the Shramiks, right? Important questions possibly can be asked in your upcoming prelims examination. So do participate, write your answer in the comment section down below. And if you have not taken the subscription, today is the last day to take the subscription. You can register for an year subscription, which is available at the affordable price, which include the courier charges as well. So do get your hand on it so that you can have an excel on the current affairs, right? So do check it out in the description section of the video where I provided a dedicated link to register for this year subscription. Right? So this was all about the daily news and editorial analysis followed by the MCQs question. If you have any other concern, do let me know. I'll be more than happy to assist you. For time being, I'm signing off. Wish you all the best. Thank you so much for listening.